What is up, Marvel Universe community? It's Ash Rock back with another review. This is on the Fantastic Four box set that just recently came out. Just got mine in the mail a couple days ago from BBTS. So we're start off right off the bat with box art. So let me move the camera over here. So really, really cool with the box art. Very similar to the X-Force and the Classic Avengers box art. Awesome art. Love it, man. Really pops out at you. And then you got the Fantastic Four logo there, the various characters, Invisible Woman, Mr. Fantastic, Herbie, and Thing. And I'll talk about Herbie in a second. I had to do some research on that bad boy. On the back, you got them again in the box. Steve Rogers saying, collect them all. Well, he's not saying it, actually. All right, whatever. He's just pointing at us. You! Anyways. And then the you got some other box, the Classic Avengers box set, which I also did a review on my channel, and collect them all. There it is, collect them all, sold separately. You bastards. So here they are, the Fantastic Four. So I had to do a little bit of research, as I said, on Herbie in particular. I'm not too familiar with the character. So I guess, you know, thank God for this thing called the internet and Wikipedia. Herbie. First of all, it's an acronym, and it stands for Humanoid Experimental Robot B-Type Integrated Electronics. So say that 10 times real fast. Anyways, he was created, I guess, in a series, an animated series in 1979. Human Torch was not put in the team because they were supposed to work on a solo movie for Human Torch, which never really generated, never came out. So Stan Lee gave some of the other execs an idea for a robot, a cute, cuddly little robot that's, you know, kind of a smart ass and stuff like that. And that's where he was created from. So this box set is actually more from that genre and from that particular series. So there you go. So here we go. We'll start off with Mr. Herbie. He's very, very cool looking. I know it's kind of cartoony and geeky looking. And, you know, but he's really cool. You're a good robot, aren't you? Oh, yes, you are. There's no real articulation anywhere around here on his base, but the head is on a ball joint, so kind of neat. So you could have him in little cute, cuddly, you know, poses like, huh? What'd you say about my mama? But really, really cool. Head pops off. There you go. Let's put it back on before the kids start screaming. But yeah, it's really, really neat. I like the little bit of detail that went into the face and stuff like that. Again, very cartoony, but I think it's really, really neat. Mr. Fantastic and Invisible Woman. Let's bring them both in here. You got this very, very cool blue. This is probably my favorite blue, to be honest with you guys, throughout. And let me take them off the base. So really, really neat with the blue. And then you got the black trimming throughout. Lots of shading went into it as well. As you can see there, there's a lot of different shading. It's not just plain blue. So it's really, really neat. Comes all the way around to the back. You got his signature gray hair on the sides. Really, really cool. And a really cool face sculpt. This is the other one here. This is Mr. Fantastic from the comic 2-pack. The comic 2-pack series. Which came with... Who did he come with? Ultron. So this one I thought was a hell of a weak figure. Didn't like him at all, really. But this one here is definitely cool. So, and I'm not even a big fan of Mr. Fantastic, to be honest with you guys. It's probably my least favorite from the four original members. And then Sue Richards, or Sue Storm, whatever you want to call her. Really cool. So the first time we're seeing her in this line, the Marvel Universe line, which is really, really cool. Again, the same kind of shading throughout. Really like the lines and stuff like that. And as I caress her breast. I really like the, where am I? Okay, anyways, so, yeah, and then you got the solid blonde hair. Really neat with the face sculpt. I think they did a really cool job with it. And then the skin color and stuff like that really matches throughout. So really, really cool. And, sorry. But yeah, really, really cool figure. You guys are going to start spreading rumors. Ash plays with his toys in disgusting ways, you know? Look at her. She's about to bitch slap me. Anyways, but yeah, I like it a lot. Really, really neat with the paint apps for her as well. They did use the older mold, obviously. We'll get to that when we're talking about articulation. And then the Thing. He is basically the comic pack, the two-pack series, again, from the Secret Wars. He comes with... Who does he come with? Thing comes with Bulldozer. So it's basically this exact same one. This one has more of a glossy finish on his skin, on the rocks. And this one's a little more dull, but there is a little bit of glossiness as well. But it's two different shades of orange, I guess. Really, really cool. So this one, he's wearing his little underwear. So it's kind of disgusting, but whatever. But really, really neat. But it's the exact same figure, just a different color tone here. And obviously the different with the shorts as well. So I like the shorts a lot. So really, really neat. So for Pain Apps, I'm actually going to give them a 5 out of 5. I know it's a lot of... simplistic colors, but I do like the way they look, and I like the addition of Herbie here. He's a cool looking dude, cool looking robot. So articulation, I'm gonna go over all of them, whatever. So ball joint up here, single jointed elbows, wrist rotates all the way around, head rotates 360, no ab crunch or no waist articulation, but he does have the ab crunch there. So it rotates there. Ball joint here, double jointed knees, and then the foot rotates all the way around as I knock down Kirby. Or Kirby, whatever. And then with her, you got it's the older female mold. We're not going to see the new one until X-23. So you got the same crappy mold with the gigantic, I can't stop. All right, anyways, but so yeah, it's the older ones. They got the ball joint up there, single jointed elbows, wrist rotates all the way around, head rotates 360. She does have waist articulation, so that's cool. And then the upper ab crunch, ball joint, double jointed knees, and the foot rotates 360. So again, not the best articulation, but whatever. They are using the older molds. And then the Thing, you got the ball joint up here, single jointed elbows, wrist rotates all the way around. It also rotates at the elbow part too, so that's pretty cool. And then the head rotates 360. No waist articulation, but he does have the ab crunch, so you could have him in some cool poses with the ab crunch. Ball joint up here, but it's limited with some of these bigger characters, obviously. Single jointed knee. And then the foot rotates all the way around and goes up and down. And really cool with the up and down. Real good up and down motion there. So for articulation, I'm going to actually give them a 4 out of 5. Not the best articulation, again, because they are using the older molds, but it's not a big gripe. It's not a big deal. I'm still digging it. And the final score is going to be a 4 out of 5. It's not a perfect set, but they did do a really good job with the Pain Apps. I definitely say it's worth picking up. They are not an exclusive. I did get a couple questions about, is it an exclusive to a certain store? It is not. I haven't seen them at the stores yet, but they are. They'll probably be available pretty soon. Like the X-Force and the... Classic Avengers. The only gripe, I guess, is if you have Human Torch and you kind of want to do a build a team and stuff like that, it's a little difficult. You do have this Human Torch here, which is from the first series. I do have the light variant as well, the light skin variant, but I don't have them on me. I couldn't find them for the life of me. I apologize, guys. But even that one, which here's a picture of them here. Even that one is not, does not match the colors that these guys have here. Again, these are based on the cartoon. You have this. This is the San Diego Comic-Con exclusive, the 2009 Invader set. So you're not really going to use him as well. I mean, it's obviously a different setting. This is the one that came with Red Skull, Captain America, and what's his name? Red Skull, Captain America, and Namor. You got this one here. This is part of the comic two-pack series as well. He came with Wolverine, so it doesn't really match with these guys. And then you got this one here, the Flame On one, which is becoming more and more available right now in the stores because of a revision series that came out recently. So for me, I guess this would be, the best choice, really, kind of a Flame On version, which is not too bad. It gives it a little different dynamic. So we take this bastard and say, see you later, biatch. And then you got Human Torch there, and it's not a bad set. So thank you guys so much for watching. Just real quick, I did pick up the Falcon and Scarlet Spider. So I'll be reviewing those next week. I was at Target with my girl. We were out all day, which explains why this review has been put up so late. But, you know, we were at the Target by her house, and we walk in there, and she's like, where are you going to be? And I'm like, I looked at her, and she knew exactly where the fuck I was going to be. So she didn't have to say anything. But, and I walked in there, and they were there, man. I found them along with the Scar. I picked one up for my boy. And then the Doctor Doom. So, but no Doctor Strange figures there at all. If there was, my man Tiberius, you knew I would have got you, man. So, anyways, thank you guys so much for watching. Tiberius? Anyways, thanks so much for watching. I'll talk to you guys in a week. Have a good one. Peace.